outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you how I made these paper spirals, which you can use to decorate a tree. They look very effective against a green fir tree, or you can hang them wherever you like. What we've got here are some musical spirals, which are made out of sheet music. And we also have this one, which was made using plain paper, just plain white paper, and was decorated by hand. I'm going to show you how I made this particular one today. Now I have a sort of confession to make. It's sort of a brag and sort of a confession both at the same time. I first made one of these spirals when I was about five, maybe six. And so I was in infant school at the time. It was a combined infant and junior school. And so all of the children made decorations for a kind of winter fair. And we had a competition of who could make the best decoration. And apparently I won. Or at least that's what my mum says. I had it in my mind that I got third prize. But my mum's quite convinced that I won, even though a lot of the other children taking part were in junior school, so they might have been as old as 10 or 11. And so I won, possibly first prize, with a paper spiral very much like this one. And that very same decoration that I made, after all these years, still hangs on my parents' Christmas tree every year, and it still looks really good. So that's why it's a little bit of a brag. But it's also kind of a confession, because you would think, wouldn't you, that since I was 5 or 6, my crafting skills would have improved. But they haven't. And so that is still the pinnacle of my decoration-making achievements. So that's why when I was wondering what to do for my next video, I decided to share that story with you and demonstrate that my skills have not improved since I was 5. So let's crack on. I'll show you everything that you need to make these paper spirals, and then we can make some together. So in terms of materials, I've got 2 different types of paper. If you have received one of our art packs, you will have some of this sheet music in your pack. I've got some of that. But I've also got some plain white A4 paper, the plainest of the plain, and that's what I'm going to demonstrate making the spiral with today. I've got something to draw around, this round tumbler. I've got pencil and scissors. I've got some thread, some cotton. You can use any colour. I'm going for red because I think it's festive. So that's going to be for hanging our spiral. I have a needle, which is going to make it easier for me to thread the cotton through. And then because I'm using plain white paper to demonstrate, I've got various things to decorate that paper with. I've got some Posca pens and also some finer nibbed pens in red and green. I've got this gold pen. And I've got some glitter. So you could use some loose glitter and Pritt stick, or you could use glitter glue. So let's start. So we start super easy by drawing around our tumbler. So I've got a circle and I want 2 of these. So I'm going to fold my paper over and I'm going to cut out the circle that I've just drawn, because I've folded the paper. That will result in me having 2 circles. Okay, so we now have 2 identical circles. To turn them into a spiral, we're going to start at one edge. It doesn't matter where in the circle you start. And we're going to draw a spiral shape on about a centimetre wide from the edge, keeping it relatively even, but it doesn't have to be too exact. And also, if anything, I want the the width of each layer, the width of each coil, to become slightly narrower towards the centre. So if the first outer ring was about a centimetre, it might become slightly less than a centimetre towards the middle. But as you can see, I'm just doing this by eye, it's not like I'm measuring it, and it doesn't have to be super exact. And then I don't know if you can see that, it spirals around, and then that line doesn't join up to the other line, it just kind of stops in the middle. And I'm still holding my two pieces, my two circles together. And I'm going to cut out my spiral.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful.
Now, I didn't mention using a rubber, but if you want to, you can, of course, rub out the pencil marks that you made earlier. So we separate out those two circles, or those two spirals. And what we want is for these two to be mirror images of one another, or to spiral in different directions. So the way that you can check for that is that if the tail on this one points to my right, then I want the tail of this other one to point to my left, which is easily enough achieved. I just turn that over. And since this was the one with the pencil marks on, by turning that over, I save myself a job. I don't really have to rub out the pencil marks because they're not really going to be seen. So now we have two spirals that are mirror images of one another. The next bit is where you get to decorate your spirals however you want to. If you're using this sheet music paper, you might not need to decorate it further at all or very much. You might want to add some glitter to it or some additional drawing, but maybe you'll decide that you don't need to. For this plain white paper, it does need some decoration. So on one side, I'm going to draw some little holly berries and leaves. And on the other side, I'm going to draw some stars or just some blobs of glitter. I'm going to glitter it up. To draw holly berries, we draw three little red dots. Like that. And you can do them kind of the opposite way as well. You see? I'm going to go all around the edge, all around each of the coils, doing little red berries like that. So now for each of these clusters of holly berries, there need to be two holly leaves either side. And the holly leaf shape looks like this. So I went 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to go around my spiral again. Everywhere where I drew a cluster of three berries, I'm going to do two holly leaves sticking out either side. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And actually, because these are quite small, if you find that you do end up simply drawing diamond shapes, that would be fine too, because it's on quite a small scale. It's not even really that noticeable, the difference. So here I drew my holly leaves with multiple points, and here I literally just drew diamond shapes. I'll colour those in so they're a little bit clearer. You see? So they're literally just diamonds, but they give the overall effect. Alright, so if you were to look closely, you'd see that some of these holly leaf shapes are pretty tenuous, but it gives the overall effect, doesn't it? And I'll draw some gold stars on the other side. To draw a star, I'll do it in this red pen so that you can see it more easily. I go like this. One, two, three, four, five. As you can see, there's nowhere near as many gold stars as there were holly leaves and berries. I'm also going to add just some blobs of glitter, just because I can. Okay, so I've now got my two decorated spirals. One is quite busy with holly leaves and berries, the other is a bit more delicately decorated with just some gold stars, a little bit of silver glitter that you can just about see catching the light there. Now the next step is the slightly tricky bit, or rather the bit that when I was five somehow seemed to be quite self-explanatory, but now that I'm an adult, seems a bit weird. I've got my needle already threaded up with some red cotton. I'm going to take my two spirals, and making sure that the tail of one is pointing in one direction, and the tail of the other is pointing in the other direction, I sort of slide them together, like this. And when I get to the top, I pinch the top two bits together. And then, so pinching the top two bits together, you then just need to keep moving the paper around. Just keep sort of styling it with your fingers. And the bit that I find strange or uncomfortable is that the paper will sort of bunch up at the top, and it, the narrower the coils are here, this is why I mentioned earlier to possibly cut slightly narrower as you go towards the middle of the spiral. So if these sections are quite narrow, they don't bunch up as much. So then I take my needle, which I've already threaded, and I'm going to puncture the centre so it's gone through the top of both spirals. And I pull out enough that I'll then be able to hang it from a tree or whatever I want to be able to hang it from. And then, so I kind of loop, want to be able to loop the string over, and then go back in with a needle and once again puncture the paper in a slightly different spot, just a few millimetres away from where you punctured it before. So I don't know if you can just see there. And then of course we trim it. We tie the thread in a double knot. This is the kind of thing that is incredibly difficult to do when you've got people watching you. I can't do it. Well, you all know what a double knot looks like. I've got now this loop of cotton. You see? So now here's the finished product. This is the spiral that was made out of plain paper. And these two were made out of the sheet music, the musical paper. And I think they're all really effective. The plain paper one, I promise you, the one I made when I was little was way better than this, and I don't really understand why. I probably did spend longer decorating it with glitter and whatnot, but also it kind of hung better, so it's mysterious. But I'm really happy with the way that these ones look. think with these, I have cut the coils slightly more narrow than I did with this, and I think that does make a difference. So we want to aim for quite narrow corkscrew spirals. So we look forward to seeing what you come up with in the coming weeks. As always, please send us your photos. I'm going to share now some photos that we took last Saturday. As some of you know, because some of you were there, we were invited by a local organisation called Moseley Together to go and decorate a tree in Moseley Park. And all of our participants who got involved did an amazing job getting a lot of decorations together in really a short space of time. I think we only had about a week. We were so impressed by the amount and the quality of decorations that we managed to get together. We had pom-pom garlands, we had gingerbread men, gingerbread sculptures of different kinds. We had some beautifully painted wood slices, and they looked great when we put them on the tree. So I'm just going to end this video by sharing some of those photos, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow.